Manamana. Manamana.
Hey, this is Braden Barty and
Lee Schneider.
And we're at EVS here in Glendale, California. We were trying out the Ronin M just shipped this week, and we noticed that it works really well, and we want to prove it with the Canon C300. And we're going to mount these, and we're going to show you guys basically how it works. Lee was the first one to kind of unwrap this and to go through the manual. So why don't we have Lee just kind of give us a rundown of the Ronin M.
Okay, so first step is making sure you set up the stand. You got four little points of contact here. You can also mount this on a C stand. So this top part just unscrews. You can change your height so you don't hit the ground or whatever table you're working from. Important first step is setting it up, putting all the handles on. You're gonna unscrew these and just build a nice solid base, and then you attach our mount. And then once you have that all mounted, you're gonna attach this universal base plate to your camera on the bottom. And once you have that all set up, you start placing it in the center of the rig, and it's gonna take about 30 minutes to set first time minimum.
So Lee first balanced his 7D, and we noticed that all the demo videos had like a DSLR mini camera on there. That's fine. So our curiosity before we actually bought the Ronin M, which really wasn't shipping out yet, was, you know, well, how well would it work with the C300 and the Red? So the kind of larger DSLR. Now that this, obviously the cameras need to be stripped down completely, as you see, which the C300 does. Without the lens, you're looking at 4 pounds. Okay, so it's pretty light still. Now with the lens, this is a prime lens. You now added about another pound and a half, so roughly about, you have about 5-6 pounds right here, and it still works wonderfully. The limit on here is 8 pounds.
Right.
So we don't know the weight on this Scarlett. We just realized you got to put a battery on here.
Right. It might be closer to about, this is pushing 8 pounds as is, maybe closer to 10. So
people who are viewing this, if you have any other suggestions about, you know, external power sources, because that's really where all our weight is going. Now, again, not to get confused, people are thinking, you know, where the weight is distributed. Now, the weight, when they say weight limit, it's just in the gimbal itself.
You can put all of your monitors and mics and anything you need up top here on the handles, but it's got to be 8 pounds or less inside the cage.
Okay, so from this point on, it took me, how long did it take you first to do your 7D balancing?
The overall time, I mean, about an hour to totally get ready to run.
All right, and that's
going really slow,
getting
methodical.
Up to speed.
Yes, getting up to speed first time out of the box.
The first shot, right when I balanced, the second shot is this one right here. It's just me and my kids and my neighborhood friends just doing their scooters down a hill, and that was me running. Yeah, I do have experience doing camera work, but this is my first time working a Ronin M, actually a gimbal at all, to be honest with you. So it was kind of cool with the results, as you see. It's really smooth, everything is running well, and I'm just running with them. So it turned out pretty good. So we're gonna continue testing it here with the C300, and we're gonna mount it. All right, now we got it fully balanced. Again, you can go online, you can look at all the instructionals, whatever it takes to balance it, tilt, pitch,
roll,
whatever, okay? And you wanna get it as close to being to standing by itself without it being on, because again, it makes the motors work less. So what we're missing now, obviously, as you see, we had to take off the Canon C300 monitor, and we have to use an external monitor. And I know with that also comes the sound, but we're not gonna do sound today, but if you want, don't forget, there's also a sound, non-XLR, there's a mini connector. You can also put a sound recording device on the side here. So you actually don't need the supplied C300 monitor that comes with it. You could go without, and which is what we're doing in this review demonstration here today. So we have a Black Pearl monitor, So go ahead and hold the camera, Lee.
Make sure the camera is and the Ronin are off when you do this.
All right, so now we're going to put on... Now, this monitor originally goes with my DJI Phantom 2, and it's going to work with this because it's really light monitor, which is makes it a bonus monitor. So we're going to open this up, depending how you operate it. What's that?
Should we leave room for the handle?
Oh, yeah. Let's leave room for the handle. Yeah,
just so you can go into briefcase mode.
There we go.
Switch your hand position.
So we're going to keep it like this. Now, okay, it's going to tilt the bars a little bit more, but that's fine. It's still balanced down here. This is where the balance really counts. But before we turn it on, we're going to have to calibrate it. And it's much better to calibrate it with the HDMI cable in place. So I'm going to use this HDMI cable. I'm going to put two loops on there. It's good to have a little slack. I'm going to put it under the bars. You see here, it is taking sort of two people. You can do this by yourself, but the more the merrier. See with me. So there we go. Slack is good. And we're going to connect this right down here in the back. And now we're going to turn it on. So Lee is going to take over.
Yep. Hold it. I got it.
So now we're all set.
Ronin goes on. It'll be a very light touch here. It's going to balance. It's going to find its balance. And then we open the app and we get into, we go set our auto-tune stability. And it's going to balance it. These are little micro adjustments.
What's the app called again?
The DJI Assistant.
DJI Assistant.
All right. So now it should be decently connected. We're sitting, -5 is pushing it a little bit. But that's because we have this cable connected. So usually you want the soft, really soft flex cable, shorter cables.
Yeah. And it will be harder to balance it with the cable on, by the way.
Okay, so we're balanced. Now we're going to start rolling with it. So record here. Camera is rolling.
All right, let's go around EVS.
Let's take a tour.
Let's have the crew check it out. All right.
Phenomena. Yep. I think so. So still in follow mode here. We go to the showroom here. Phenomena. Let's switch over to handle mode. It's a low mode. Oh, this is working very smooth. I think we must adjust the smooth track just to get a little bit more follow here, but overall, it's extremely smooth. It's all about a perfect balance on this one. So once you got the balance, you're all set. Well, there's operator mode and there's follow mode.
What about the briefcase mode?
Briefcase mode is difficult to do with a monitor. Well, you can drop it down and run briefcase. Yeah. So I don't think we have briefcase mode on actually. So we get back to a normal. We're gonna move it around, get it stabilized, get it centered. It's gonna center itself. Switch off. Make sure you get a good grip. We're still going right. And there's a lot of operational modes you can use, a lot of different holds. But you can run pretty fast. Extremely smooth. First time, it gets a little heavy after a while, but you know, it's this is still about 12, right. Still about 12 pounds. And you got your monitor all set there.
Don't push your back. Okay. Is it an improvement?
Much lighter than the original, making it a lot easier to handle. I feel like I could hold it a lot longer throughout the day.
Okay. Easy rig wouldn't hurt?
Easy rig would definitely be an added value.
Okay.
But definitely can feel the weight difference, and that's key. That's clutch.
I like how much lighter it is. That's probably the biggest thing. Definitely. The fact that it's so much lighter.
All right, cool. Well, that's the Ronin M. It also has, you know, we can do another video which shows you how the remote works with it. You basically just turn the remote on, and it's in its own little, what's it called?
This is operator mode.
Operator mode. So there we go. We
so
got
nice small adjustments. You don't want to go too crazy with the pan and tilt.
You can control fine tune. Look how smooth that is. That's the pan right there. Look at that. Pan left. Watch me tilt. Up.
That's restricted by
We're restricted by the HDMI cable. Tilt down. You know, we got the roll. So where can you use the where can you use this?
This is huge for when you're on a set with two operators. So you have one operator running the camera. And you'd have a second operator on the remote with a monitor. That way, both operators can control exactly where the director wants the shot to be.
So and also,
And you have a handle. You can do briefcase mode. You can come down and switch from a low to a high.
You can put on a jib. Is what I'm saying.
Yep. You can put on a jib. You can put on a drone, helicopter, car mount. Lots of different mounts. This handle and these side handles all detach with this screw right here. There's a little button in the back. You just unclip it, and it has it's sort of a universal DJI mount.
So it's like two tools for the price of one almost. All right. So I would like to, that pretty much just sums it up. As you see, we give it positive feedback. I would like to thank EVS for allowing us in here. You can purchase the Ronin M or rent the Ronin M right here at EVS in Glendale. And also, if you want to rent us, we are also operators and DPs. Shadow Storm Productions, and check out more of our stuff online. So that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching this demonstration of DJI's latest new toy, the Ronin M. We'll see you in the next video. We'll go more in depth with other options, and we might even attempt to put a Scarlet on there as well down the line.
We'll see.
We'll see what happens.
Hello? Okay.